Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. So I acknowledge that the video about killing the GE16-GTS engine has had a lot of feedback, and Toyota GR Yaris and GR Corolla owners and also many others chiming in that don't even have one of these cars. And thank you very much for the support on one side and for all the views on the other. Today I want to go a bit deeper into the topic. I don't have an engine here, but the good news is that the GR Yaris has arrived. The container is on the ground here in Gran Canaria, so hopefully in the next days we're gonna get to the car again and have it once again on the channel with us. Okay, let's go to the catch immediately. First of all, Gen 2 cars. Apparently, the Gen 2 pistons are holding up very well at the moment, and for the moment I have zero reports worldwide from all my sources about failures on this engine. So I was waiting a moment to see, will this be fixed, will it not be fixed, and what have you, and in the end the new engine appears to be fixed, and this is very good news. Why? Because it means that, at least on the engineering side, Toyota is continuing to follow through and improve and do good things. So I want to put it out there to you, if you want to buy a GR car, know that not all the GR ones are bad, and we'll get to this just now, and for sure the second generation GRs are all good. So let's come to the first generation car. I'm a first generation owner, as you know, even tuned car, and my car is perfect. But I have seen firsthand many of these problems nowadays. I mean, some weekends I get two or three different emails from people that have had their car blow up in one way or the other, just in the weekends because cars get used more, and many other contacts. So I want to tell you that this is a rare incident. Now there are many of these cars out there, and it is quite rare that this may happen. But it is an Achilles heel on this car, on this specific engine of the Gen 1. Therefore, I have suggested a number of fixes in regards both to mechanically fixing the problem by exchanging out the pistons, and just taking better care both of the engine liquids, engine temperatures, and about your driving style. So not putting the compressors, the turbo compressor outside of its range and letting the engine cool down and all of that. Fact is that many people out there are running also very poor fuel. And the poor fuel is the first cause that brings the temperatures to be more elevated and opens up to the risk of the dreaded LSPI mega detonation event, as I like to call it. So anyways, also the oils, frequent oil changes, and what I mean is that these are race cars, and for the street, of course, and these are race engines. Because if you think of the power that we are putting through only three cylinders, I mean, yes, of course, I would like the car to have four cylinders or more, but this is the engine. Therefore, this is what it is, and we need to deal with it for what it is. Said this, I do not want to kill the residual value of my own car and of all the GR market. I am very invested in this platform. Therefore, I am not here to scare people away, but I have to tell what is happening. Even more because I am unhappy of so many people chiming in with me and telling me that their warranties with stock cars have not been honored. And I made some examples in the first video. There are many other examples, but I can't speak of specific people, as you know, on the channel publicly, because I would need all sorts of consent for this. But there are many stories, and many people reach out to me with their broken engines. But these many people are a very, very small, less than 1% of the total cars that are out there. So it's not like every car is going to have this issue, especially if you take care of it well. I'm going to run my car with 350 plus horsepower, real horsepower, until something happens. And we will see how long it goes on. And then I will just pull the engine and rebuild the engine. Maybe it will cost a bit more in that way, but I want to do my own durability test and see how it works in this way. I would not want to say this is not a car to buy, because this is a very strong car. It has a beautiful chassis. If you improve on the car package itself, as we've seen already many times on the channel, every detail, every way, every possibility, you can have a car that really becomes a M2, M3 killer on certain roads. And it can really, you know, on track, give problems even to certain Porsches. I mean, this is how fast this car can be on this platform. And of course, it's all coming from a beautiful chassis that has got its limitations, as everything, you know. I mean, even Evos used to have limitations, because people went there, got an Evo and stuck 100 or 200 horsepower more on it. And especially, for example, on the six gear gearbox, there were problems because they just didn't have that strength. But it's normal, because they are race cars for the road and there are some limitations, but it was just something that you knew. And therefore, with the Yaris, you know, we pinned the engine problem to certain conditions, as I said in the first video, that are usually very high temperatures and very low engine load. So this could be cruising or stopping and just sitting in the traffic after having gone fast, or just with very high temperatures, and add maybe bad oil, SN oil, 030 SN oil, add in bad fuel, and maybe the oil is also old, and this does not help, because the oil becomes very, very liquid. And this is why you want a 5W30 or 40 oil and not a 0W, because it helps. A catch can also helps, but not this specific, but it helps the system to work better. But with this, I want to tell you that the GR Yaris are great cars. Although the cost, the price on the new ones has gone up quite a bit, the hike is important, I still think they are quite worth the money when you sit into other premium cars and you say, wow, I missed the GR. And this was the case with the G87 M2 on the rally roads. It's just like, obviously, it's not that car's ideal place. The F87 is fine, but the G87 was like crap. And I really missed the Yaris. And this is how good these cars are. And this is the possibility you have now to jump in to the Gazoo Racing Division cars with 30-35K on good, low mileage Gen 1 cars that are very, very good. So reconsider your position, because I mean, a piston job that would give you the full peace of mind on this engine, throw in also some a set of cams and springs if you want to do it, you buy a used car and you do all this job, and let's say that with 5 to 7,000 euros difference in price, you've got a new engine on a car that maybe has 10 or 20,000 kilometers that will be bulletproof. Bulletproof, even if you throw at it 450, 500 horsepower, it will still be. So this engine is not a shit. This is a work of prodigious engineering. It is normal that when engineers push the boundaries and push the limits, the problems come out. What is not normal is how they have been managing the warranty claims and how they've been trying to pass these issues that they know of very well from Toyota as customers' issues, customers' mistreatments and all that, because it's not true. So with this, I'll leave you, and in the next days, we're gonna go pick up together, because I'll bring somebody with a camera and film the opening of the container with the GR Yaris. We'll get it out and get back into the usuals And then we are starting with the deliveries and getting everything up for the online shop. I know many of you are asking for the products. We're almost there, but I want to release when everything is just stunning and perfect, as much as we are capable of doing. So thank you for following. Thank you for the support, and have a good one. Cheers.